Right wing that goes to Royce. To McClintock inside. Leo Martinez with that three. And it's 9-7 now, Jeff. As Twin Lakes is on a 5-0 run after the timeout. Three ball on the other end, missed by Munoz. Twin Lakes with the rebound. Down by two. Here they come into the front court. Martinez with it. Right wing guarded by Koger. Now to Hassan. Hassan tries to drive on Gamble and dishes to Martinez between the circles, top of the key. The Indians down by a bucket. High post with it, McClintock. Now over in the far corner it goes to Hassan. A skip pass to Runyon. He launches another deep jumper and hits again. This one a two. Actually, his first bucket of the ball game. We're tied at 9 here with 2:58 to go. On the other end, getting free underneath for a bucket is Shane Lyon, who checked in for Jeff. And it's 11-9 now. Broncos up in this one. Front court with it, Runyon. Left wing for the Indians. He'll shoot a three. And rattled out. Rebound grabbed by Lyon of the Broncos. To Munoz, baseline right on the drive, and threw it in. Excellent move by Munoz, a tough shot. He's got 5, 13-9 Broncos.
Looks almost as if he was trying to draw a foul there, but he managed to put the shot through and no foul called.
Martinez with the ball on the front court for the Twin Lakes Indians. They're down by 4. High post now to Hassan. Hassan looks for help and had the dribble, now bounces to in the near corner, and firing a triple is Tyler Royce. His first three. Twin Lakes to within one now, 13-12. Front court with it for Jeff. Joe Gamble in the lane. And a little runner in the lane is missed. Rebound to Twin Lakes. They can grab the lead. Long lead pass into the front court. Driving the baseline and missing their running layup try is Runyon. Rebound to Martinez for the Indians, and he's fouled on a putback try. So Diversio Martinez to the foul line to try and give the Indians a lead.
The Broncos are starting to play a little sloppier here. Still trying to keep up the pace, but they are starting to turn over the ball and also get a couple fouls here.
Shane Wyatt picked up his first personal team foul, number 2. Martinez, the foul shooter for the Indians, makes the first. He's got 3 points, tying the ball game at 13. We get Jeff's substitution. Number 34, Timmy Fogarty, checks in, as well as number 14, Jesse Berry. Martinez, second free throw is good. The Indians now lead 14-13 with 1:40 to go on the other end. We've got a loose ball on the baseline, and the Indians come away with a steal. Raiderstorff with it in the front court. He checked in on that last dead ball. Raiderstorff comes down the lane, and he's fouled on his way to the bucket. And the official says he was in the act of shooting, so 2 free throws for Zach Raiderstorff and Twin Lakes. As Shane Wyatt just picked up his second personal foul.
That could turn out to be important because Shane Wyatt is the biggest guy for the Broncos, and if he starts getting in foul trouble, that'll put the Broncos into some problems underneath the basket.
So 6'2 Wyatt with 2 personals as Zach Raiderstorff scores his first point from the foul line for Twin Lakes. The Indians lead 15-13. Wyatt checks out now, replaced by Jordan Oakley. Raiderstorff, second free throw is missed. And a leaping rebound by Jeff Jordan Oakley. Here come the Broncos into the front court. Far corner with it was Koger. Coming down the lane on a runner, Munoz, and he's, no, he scored, but the officials wave it off, and they call Caesar for a charge. Caesar with his second personal foul, and 4th turnover for the Broncos.
Well, that was big. That's not what Jeff wants. That's a classic Cesar Munoz style, driving right to the basket and stopping, putting the ball up, but he was a call for the charge right there.
Well, you can tell the Indians are well scouted in this game, Paul. They know that Cesar does like to try that drive down the middle of the lane, and they were waiting for him that time.
That's exactly right.
The Indians with the ball, front court, a substitution is Darren Paul with the ball, far sideline to Raiderstorff now. Raiderstorff on that far sideline, guarded very closely by Berry. Raiderstorff picked up his dribble, gets it in the corner to Paul. Now on the baseline, back to Paul, and Paul traveled. David Schulteis, who checked in, got Paul the pass, but Paul guilty of a travel. 4 Indian turnovers now. Both teams unofficially with 4 turnovers. Jeff down by 2:15:13. Here's another Indian steal into the front court. Raiders score, had it stripped away from him underneath the bucket. Great hustle by Jesse Berry there to knock that one away.
Sloppy passing on the other end of the court there, but a good hustle by Jesse Berry. He managed to knock that ball away as that number 11, Raidersdorf, is going in for the layup.
Martinez inbounding baseline right for the Indians. His club up 15-13. His inbound pass is intercepted by Joe Gamble. So 43 seconds to go. Gamble goes coast to coast, missed the layup. Fogarty grabs the rebound, and he's hacked on a putback try. So Timmy is going to earn two free throw opportunities here for the Broncos. As Tiburcio Martinez charged for his first foul, team foul number four. So 15-13 Twin Lakes in this one. Fogarty's your foul shooter here for the Broncos. Free throw by Fogarty is no good. Rattled out. Another Indian substitution. We get number 44 into the ball game, and we're going to have to double check that here and find out who 44 is. As Fogarty makes the second free throw here. Fogarty makes one of two for the Broncos. It's 15-14 Twin Lakes. 36 seconds to go here in the first quarter. The Indians, as I said, by one. Martinez with the ball in the front court, guarded by Coger. Loose ball, and it's going to be picked up by Oakley for the Broncos. He drives and is fouled prior to the shot. Number 44, our mystery man, picked up that foul. We've been pointed out his name, A.J. Ellis. He was not in the program here tonight for Twin Lakes. Bronco ball, they get it in underneath. Fogarty had his shot blocked, and now we get a whistle and a stoppage of play here as the ball goes out of bounds. And we'll see what we've got here. We've got a Bronco foul on that rebound. Joe Gamble just picked up his first personal, team's fifth for the Broncos. And Coach Bunnell comes out to argue a point here with an official. 22 seconds to go. Indians with the ball up by a point. Royce with the ball, front court. Far sideline now to Martinez. Hawks by Coger defensively. 13 seconds to go in the quarter. Back to Royce. Out by the half-court line. Royce comes down the left side of the lane, and he carried the basketball. Seven turnovers against the Indians. Jeff with 8 seconds to go in the quarter, down by a point. As Ken Adams gets David Schulteis off his bench for the Indians, and he replaces Tyler Runyon. 8.7 to go in the quarter. The Broncos have to go the length of the floor here. Gamble with the ball. He brings it to the front court. 6 seconds to go. Gamble drives the lane and scores on the runner. 1 second to go. Three-quarters fourth shot by Martinez is off the mark. Well short, but the bucket by Joe Gamble at the end of the quarter gives the Broncos. Jeff leads by a point, 16-15 over Twin Lakes. As we start second quarter action, the Broncos with the basketball, moving right to left. And front court with it is Fogarty, and he had the ball deflected on a pass. And the Broncos will keep it right here. Paul, your thoughts on the first quarter of play for the Broncos? They had a quick start. The Indians rallied, though, but the Broncos cling to a one-point lead.
Yeah, both teams seem to be playing a perimeter-type offense.
As we get a three-ball buried by Blaine Coger in the far corner, his first three, 19-15 Broncos.
Both teams are playing out in the perimeter on offense mostly, but when the ball's inside, it's a very physical battle down underneath the basket.
Raidersdorf drives inside for the Indians. He is hacked on his way to the bucket, and the official signals two free throws here for Twin Lakes. As the foul's going to be called on Jesse Berry, his first, team six. 19-15 Jeff here. Raidersdorf, the free throw shooter for the Indians. He's 1-for-2 from the line. He's got 1 point in the game. Make it two. Coach Bunnell's going to make a substitution here for Jeff. Brandon Williams will check back in, replacing Jesse Berry. This is the fourth year for the J&C Hoops Classic. As Raidersdorf made a pair for the Indians. 19-17, Jeff. A little full-court pressure by the Indians. Gamble with the ball backcourt for the Broncos. Gets it in the front court to Williams. Williams with it between the circles. Now dribbles to the far sideline. Off to Gamble over there for our corner. Gamble drives down the baseline and scores. Good baseline move by Joe. He's got 6 points, 21-17 Jeff.
Yeah, Joe Gamble's doing a nice job of stepping in and taking control while Cesar Munoz is on the bench.
Cesar on the bench, picked up two fouls in the first quarter. Royce with the ball, front court playing to the Indians. Here's a cross-court pass by Hassan to McClintic, but Chandler Hassan called for a travel, and the Indians now have turned it over eight times in the ballgame. Jeff with a four-point lead. They've got the ball. Williams at the front court. Far sideline to Coger. Down on the baseline now. Dopey, nice pass inside to Timmy Fogarty. He missed the shot, though. Rebound to the Indians. Hassan brings it into the front court for Twin Lakes. In trouble on the far sideline. He calls for a timeout. He needs a timeout. It's good defensive pressure by Joe Gamble causes the Indians to call a 30-second timeout. He gets it in the backcourt to Martinez. Martinez is going to be picked up by Coger as Martinez crosses the half-court line into the front court. Now to Hassan on the left wing. Back to Martinez between the circles. Top of the key calls out the play. Martinez on the dribble. Now it comes down the right side of the lane, and he traveled on the baseline. So nine turnovers now by the Indians here in the first half.
A good defensive pressure being shown here by LeBron because Twin Lakes looks frustrated on offense, not finding some open passes.
Gamble, Williams, Fogarty, Coger, and Oakley on the floor for the Broncos as we get a Twin Lakes foul here. Picking up the foul was number 23, Tiburcio Martinez, his second, team six. 6:29 to go before the half. 21-17 Jeff. They've got the ball in the front court. Williams with it top of the key. Now on the baseline to Fogarty. Nice bounce pass down low to Oakley, and Oakley scores. Oakley with six. 23-17 Jeff.
Yeah, nice pass there by Fogarty, and they put it in. Open was Oakley.
McClintic with it. Now top of the key to Hassan. Hassan tries to drive. Stops at the foul line. This is down the baseline to McClintic. His 10-foot jumper is no good. Rebound to Gamble for the Broncos. Gamble had the ball. Dribble off his foot. The ball's loose in the backcourt. The Broncos get it back off. Good hustle from Williams. Back to Gamble. Gamble jump stop in the lane. This is to Fogarty. Fogarty. Far corner, Coger for a three try. Ring it up. Three ball there for Blaine Coger. He's got his second three. 26-17 now, Broncos.
The Broncos there did a good job of not taking the tough shot, but finding the open man for the three-pointer.
Now they get a steal, Jeff does. We get contact just across the half-court line as Joe Gamble collides with Brady Logan, and we're going to get a foul on Brady Logan. That's his third, team seventh. So we're going to get a one-and-one here for Joe Gamble. Substitution for Jeff, number 42, Henry Patterson, steps in for his first action, the 6-1 senior. Joe Gamble's got a 1-1 for the Broncos as Jeff has its largest lead of 9, 26-17. Gamble at the line, free throw good. I've got Joe unofficially now with 7 points in the first half of play. 5:31 to go before halftime as Jeff leads by double figures. Gamble eyes the second free throw. It's in the air, and it is no good. It rattled out on him. Rebound to McClintic for the Indians. To Martinez, now into the front court to Royce. Back to Martinez, left wing three ball, no good. Rebound, tipped out of bounds by Twin Lakes. Jeff with the ball, leading by 10, 27-17.
Radersdorf standing down by the free throw line, the under end of the floor as Gamble missed that free throw, and they threw it down to him, but good hustle by Blaine Coger to get down and cover him.
Williams with the ball front court, bounces far corner to Gamble. He drives the baseline, now gets by a defender, McClintic, but Joe stepped on the end line out of bounds. A Bronco turnover there, six. So the Indians with the ball down by 10 still. And it's Tiburcio Martinez with the ball in the backcourt. Guarded by Blaine Coger. Tiburcio into the front court now. Bounces back door to Radersdorf, and Radersdorf fouled on a shot. And Zach Radersdorf back to the free throw line. He is 3 of 4 from the charity stripe tonight as the foul whistled on Joe Gamble, his second, team seven. Raiders score, free throw is good. Well, he's got another player for the Indians coming in here that's not on our program. We'll have to see who that is here as Raiderstorp gets a second. Raiderstorp missed the second. It rattled out, and Henry Patterson knocked it out of bounds for the Broncos. So the Indians will keep it, trailing 27-18, 4:59 to go here in the second quarter. Passing with the ball for the Indians. Down low on the baseline to McClintock, and he scores on the jumper. McClintock with four, 27-20. On the other end, we get a offensive foul against the Broncos. Coker pulled up for a jumper in the lane. A whistle and a foul against the Broncos. Offensive foul going to go against Blaine Coker. His first team's eight. 4:44 to go. Second quarter from the Crawley Center. Twin Lakes with the ball down by 7, 27-20. It's Royce with it front court. Dishes over in the far corner there to Raiderstorp. The Indians reverse the ball to Billings now on the right side. He wears number three. Royce with it now on the right wing, guarded by Fogarty. Royce to the baseline to Billings. Fires a three ball in the corner. It's a little long. Rebound to Patterson for the Broncos. Patterson races into the front court. Comes down the lane. Goes coast to coast and scores. Henry Patterson with his first two, 29-20. The Indians a long outlet pass to the other end. On the baseline, Hassan missed the shot. Rebound tipped out to Fogarty. Fogarty to the other end. Down the left side of the lane. His layup is good. So Jeff with two great moves, coast-to-coast moves, ball by Patterson and then by Fogarty, and they lead by 11, 31-20.
Yeah, Patterson and Fogarty are two guys that that Coach Bunnell really want really
in the game. Indian basketball in backcourt. Tiburcio Martinez with it. Coker, the defensive alignment, assignment there. Front court, far corner with it. Raiderstorp, he fell down, threw the ball to Grass. Martinez, a great catch, and he goes right to the goal and scores. Nice move by Martinez. He's got six, and the Broncos nearly throw it away on the other end, and the front court ball tipped out of bounds by Twin Lakes.
It looked like down the other end of the floor, all the Broncos were already headed down the floor for the fast full court offense, but none of them managed to get the rebound.
Tyler Runyon checks in for Twin Lakes. 3:45 to go first half, 31-22. Jeff, they've got the ball. Fogarty with it. Far sideline to Coker. Inside to Fogarty. He's double teamed. He puts up a shot anyway. It wouldn't roll. Rebound tipped around. Grabbed on the baseline by McClintock. Now to Raiderstorp for the Indians. He gives to Hassan and right back to Raiderstorp again. He looked to the bench and got the play call. Raiderstorp with it front court. Off to McClintock, top of the key. Guarded there by Oakley. He bounces to Hassan. We've got contact. And we're going to have a foul on Jeff Henry Patterson, his first, team's ninth. So a 1-1 here for the Indians.
Yeah, that was not a good foul for Henry Patterson. Pretty obvious, an easy one for the refs to call, and not one that he should have done.
Free throw shooter for Twin Lakes is going to be Chandler Hassan. He's got 2 points in the ball game. No free throw attempts yet. He'll get one here momentarily. Jeff substitution here. Shane Wyatt checks into the lineup, replacing Jordan Oakley. So Shane comes back in with two personals. 3:18 to go in the half. Shane had an excellent second half in the season opening win against Roscoe. 10 points all in the second half as the free throw is made here by Hassan. Hassan with three. Hassan makes a pair. Broncos with the ball, front court, Patterson inside to Wyatt. Wyatt spins in the lane, a little jump hook, wouldn't fall. Rebound to Twin Lakes. Hassan with the rebound, 31-24 Jeff, as we've got straight up 3 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Raiderstorp with it, front court, bounces far sideline to Runyon. Now inside in the lane, and a shot is McClintock, and he scores. He got the friendly roll. J.D. McClintock with six. 31-26. Jeff right back up the floor. Williams with it to Patterson, high left wing. He wants to drive, does Henry. His shot in the lane. Good. Good drive by Patterson. He's got four. 33-26, Jeff. 2:28 to go here in the half. Raiders score up with the ball, crosses the half-court line for the Indians. Far sideline it goes to Runyon, guarded very closely by Patterson. In the far corner to Raiderstorff, now to Hassan. Hassan on the dribble, over on that far sideline, now moving to his right, then back to his left, guarded by Fogarty. To Raiderstorff again. Raiderstorff gets a screen, tried to come down the lane, and he is going to draw a foul here. Picking up the foul is Brandon Williams, his first, and that's the team 10th. So two free throws for the Indians, trailing 33-26. Zach Raiderstorff, the free throw shooter, he's 4 of 6 from the foul line in the first half. Make it 5 of 7. He's got 5 points. He's all from the foul line. 33-27, Jeff. Raiderstorff fires the second free throw, and he made 1 of 2. Rebound tipped out to Williams of the Broncos. And Williams will bring it into the front court. Far sideline to Patterson. Patterson drives inside, pulls up for a 15-footer on the wing. No good. Offensive rebound to Jeff Shane Wyatt, but he had it taken away by Zach Raiderstorff.
The Broncos are really starting to play sloppier here.
7 Bronco turnovers. Raiderstorff with the ball front court. Stop, top of the key. Off to McClintock. McClintock looks inside. Now to Hassan. Pull-up jumper from the foul line. He banks it in. Chandler Hassan with his second field goal. He's got 6 points, 33-29, Jeff. On the other end, Fogarty with the ball. Jeff gets the ball up in the front court quickly. Fogarty drives inside, down to the baseline to Wyatt, and he scores. Shane Wyatt with his second bucket, 35-29 Broncos. 1:15 now to go before the halftime intermission. Raiderstorff front court, top of the key to McClintock, clear for the Indians, guarded by Wyatt. McClintock bounces in the lane to Hassan. Hassan scores. So Hassan scored back-to-back buckets. Jeff by 4, 35-31. The defense has kind of let the Broncos down here late, Paul.
Yep.
On the other end in the lane, Shane Wyatt got the friendly roll. So he scored back-to-back buckets, 37-31. As I say that, both defenses have kind of let their respective coaches down here late stage of second quarter. 37-31, Jeff. Inside pass from Hassan to Runyon. He missed the shot. The ball goes out of bounds to the Broncos. Jordan Oakley back in for Jeff, replacing Shane Wyatt. And now Tyler Royce in as well for Twin Lakes. And David Schulteis have checked back in for the Indians as well. As Jeff leads 37-31, 36 seconds to go in the second quarter.
It looks as though the fast-paced offenses that both teams are using here is tiring them out for defense.
Williams with the ball front court off to Koger. Koger now to Fogarty. Far sideline to Williams. Williams moves to his left to Koger on the left wing. Koger back to Williams. Williams drives inside, and this pass is going to go into the backcourt. It was deflected by the Indians, and Fogarty saves it to Patterson. Now Williams. Koger with it again. 10 seconds to shoot. Williams with it. Backs it out to the half-court line. 7 seconds to go. To Koger on the far sideline to Williams again. 4 seconds to go. Williams jumps off in the lane. His shot is short. Rebound tip. Grabbed by McClintock at the buzzer. And that's the end of the first half as Lafayette Jeff will take a 6-point lead to the locker room over Twin Lakes 37-31. We'll take a 2-minute timeout.
The Indian is Chandler Hassan. He's had a lot, by my count, 6 assists and also 8 points.
Now that's a good first half ever for him. Twin Lakes with the ball front court. Raiderstorff had his pass tip, got it back, drives the lane, misses the shot, gets his own rebound, and dishes off to Martinez in the corner. And we're going to pick up have a Bronco. Well, we had a stoppage of play. I guess Jeff knocked it out of bounds. Martinez inbound, baseline left for the Indians. And he gets it in to Tyler Runyon, who starts here in the second half of the Indians. Raiderstorff with it, double team to Hassan. Far corner, McClintock misses a jumper, rebound to Hassan, and he's all over the place, as you said, Paul, and he scores on the baseline. So Chandler Hassan with 10, 37-33, Jeff on top. And the ball is knocked away from Oakley in the front court for Jeff, and they turn it over. Indians into the front court, down by 4. Martinez with it, top of the key, guarded by Blaine Koger. And we get a five-second call. Good smothering defense by Blaine Coger forces the Indians into their 11th turnover.
Yeah, a little bit of an erratic pass there from Blaine Coger, a risky pass, and that was taken over by the Indians, but good defense down the other end of the floor to force that violation.
Original starting five for the Broncos, Brandon Williams, Blaine Coger, Joe Campbell, Jordan Oakley, and Cesar Munoz. Munoz with it now, top of the key front court with 5 points. Dangerous pass, and the Indians are going to come away with a turnover here. And it's a foul here by Jeff to stop a what would have been a bucket on the other end, but the wrong guy picked it up, though. Cesar Munoz just got charged with his third personal.
That's not what Jeff wants at all. He was on the bench for most of the first half in foul trouble, and now it looks like he's even going to...
Remember, an eye doctor can see things you can't. For more on vision health, visit checkyearly.com. A message from the Vision Council of America and AARP.
37-33, Jeff. Twin Lakes with the basketball in front court. It's Hassan with the ball. Gives off to Martinez. He drives the right baseline. The ball's knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Lafayette. Jeff, Twin Lakes will keep the basketball. Jeff leads 37-33. 6:40 to go here in the third quarter.
Blaine Coger's limping hard. He collided with Joe Gamble. Looks like he took the worst part of the collision there.
Underneath, Hassan with the ball. His layup attempt good, and he is fouled. And Hassan has just been a load for the Broncos tonight. Chandler Hassan with 12, and if he makes the free throw, he can draw the Indians to within one. See who picked up the foul here. Foul's going to go on Joe Gamble. That's his third. As Hassan missed the free throw. Rebound to Oakley for the Broncos. Pushing up the floor, Jeff. Fogarty drives, or excuse me, it was Coger who drove the right baseline. He missed the shot, and it's rebounded out by Twin Lakes. So they can draw even on a bucket, take the lead with a three ball. Raiders throw up with the ball, top of the key. Left wing to Runyon. Now on the baseline to McClintock, to Hassan on the left wing. Hassan guarded there by Joe Gamble. Hassan wants to drive on the baseline. He turns in trouble, gets it out to Raiderstorp. In the lane to McClintock. McClintock Martinez, he drives the right side of the lane. Drew a blocking foul. So it's Tiburcio Martinez who will step to the foul line for Twin Lakes. If he hits them both, he'll be tied at 37. As the foul was called on Jordan Oakley, his first, team third of the half.
You know, Eric, Jeff certainly is not very undersized here, but the way they're playing inside, it makes it seem as if Twin Lakes is a bigger team than they are.
Free throw by Martinez is good. Tiburcio with 8 now in the ballgame for the Indians. 5:56 to go third quarter. Jeff by a point. Martinez's second free throw is swished. We're tied at 37. So Jeff has led by as many as 11 in this ballgame. Now we're tied on the other end. Coger pulls up on the right wing for a 15-footer. He missed it. Hassan, a good save on the baseline for the Indians, and now they can take the lead on this trip. Raiderstorp for the ball, far sideline. Raiderstorp to Martinez. Martinez drives down the lane, tries to dish off McClintock, and that pass goes out of bounds. A turnover for the Indians, back to the Broncos for Twin Lakes, their 12th turnover. Jeff needs a hoop right here to feel like they can get some momentum back on their side. Williams has trouble handling the ball in the front court. He does pick it up. Down low to Oakley. Drives the left baseline and scores. Jordan Oakley with 8. They've all come inside. 39-37, Jeff. And now another carry. And the officials are watching that very closely tonight. Tiburcio Martinez called for that carry. 13 Indian turnovers. Jeff by 2, they've got the ball. Front court with it, Joe Gamble. Gamble in trouble, top of the key. Now he comes down the lane and throws one up and scores. Little stutter step move by Joe Gamble. He's got 9, and I think the Indian faithful wanted to travel. None called. 41-37, Jeff. Runyon with it, front court for the Indians. On the baseline to Hassan. Hassan double team, shoots anyway and scores again. He's got 6 and a half. 14 in the game, 41-39, Jeff. Munoz with the ball. Far sideline for Jeff to Williams. Right wing to Blaine Coger. Now to Munoz. Three ball is blocked. Top of the key by Raiderstorm. Coger got the loose ball. This is down low to Munoz, and he scores. Munoz with seven. 43-39 Jeff. Tempo begins to pick up in this one. Both teams get the ball off the floor quickly off a made bucket. Near corner, front court. Corner ball, shot missed by Runyon. Rebound tipped to Martinez. He's inside. Had the ball stolen away by Gamble. His long lead pass to Coger is good for two. Coger with eight, and it's 45-39 Broncos. And now it looks like, Paul, the Indians want to slow the tempo down a little bit. I think the high-tempo game definitely favors the Broncos.
Yeah, the Indians are starting to realize, that up-tempo game is not in their advantage, and it looks like they are, as you say, they're trying to slow it down here.
And Joe Gamble nearly came away with a steal for the Broncos. Ball out of bounds on the far sideline, front court for the Indians. They're going to make a substitution here, the Twin Lakes Indians are. Number 24, Brady Logan's going to check in. We also had number 25, Tyler Royce, coming in for the Indians. And actually, it's an injury substitution here, Paul. Zach Raiderstorff's going to have to go to the bench. It looks like both of his legs actually may be bleeding. So he'll have to get that tended to. And we're going to have a stoppage of play because there's some blood out on the floor. And Jeff Clevenger, the trainer, back out of the ballgame now for the Indians. Indians with the basketball, though. Front court is Brady Logan. He gets it into the backcourt off the pass in to Royce. Royce into the front court, picked up by Blaine Coger. Far sideline to Logan. Had trouble with the ball on the far sideline and turned it over. 15 Indian turnovers now as Shane Wyatt back into the ballgame for the Broncos, replacing Jordan Oakley.
You know, I think a key for the Broncos in keeping this up-tempo up-tempo pace going has been their subs coming in and playing almost as good as their starters have been.
On the other end, Joe Gamble misses a pull-up jumper in the lane. Rebound to the Indians. Royce brings it into the front court. Top of the key to McClintock. Now to Runyon on the left wing. To Logan. Far sideline to Royce. Guarded by Coger. Man-to-man pressure by the Broncos. Far corner. Hassan in the corner. Misses a jumper long. Rebound to Williams for the Broncos. Quickly into the front court to Munoz. Munoz loses the ball. Far corner. Gets it back to Gamble in the lane. Near corner. Coger for a three try. Got it. Blaine Coger with his third three of the game. He's got 11 points total, 48-39. Jeff back up by nine now with 3:08 to go in the quarter.
Good ball moving around the floor by the Broncos down on that offensive possession.
On the other end, Royce misses a runner left side of the lane. Rebound to Munoz. Munoz bounces to Williams. His driving layup good. Brandon Williams with his first two, and Coach Ken Adams for Twin Lakes calls another timeout for the Indians. It's going to be a full timeout. Jeff has matched its largest lead now, 50-39, with 2:53 here in the third quarter. And as we pointed out just moments ago, Paul, as the pace began to quicken a little bit, the Broncos have pulled back out to an 11-point lead. As the Indians with the ball in the front court, Martinez with the ball in trouble in the far corner. Ball's loose. Martinez got it back, and he is grabbed and fouled. Broncos will pick up their 14th foul here in the half. As Shane Wyatt just picked up his third personal foul. Tiburcio Martinez inbounds, and we've got a shot blocked as Logan had a shot blocked. Hassan gets a steal, though, for the Indians. Logan's layup attempt is good underneath for Twin Lakes. His first bucket of the ball game, 50-41, and now we get a foul called on the Indians right at the half-court circle. As it appeared as though they had a steal, but the officials say no, Paul, a foul call against Twin Lakes here.
A little bit of sloppy play there with Brandon Williams. He tried to dribble behind his back there and switch hands as he was crossing the mid-court line, but the Indians got the ball, but it worked called with a foul.
Tiburcio Martinez with his third personal foul. Jeff with the ball. Gamble with it front court. Gamble, double dribble. 11 Bronco turnovers now. 2:16 to go. Third quarter, Jeff by 9, 50-41. Tyler Royce inbounds and backcourt to Martinez. Back to Royce. Munoz is going to come into the backcourt, pick up Royce. Royce now dribbles into the front court, far sideline. Pass to Logan, knocked out of bounds over there by Brandon Williams for the Broncos. So the Indians will inbound far sideline, trailing 50-41. Logan inbounding. And he gets it in to Darren Paul, who's checked back in. Loose ball. Indians retrieve the loose ball. Hassan with it. Right wing. His pass is kicked by Joe Gamble. And Jeff still leading 50-41. A couple more Indian substitutions. J.D. McClintock comes back in. And it looks like Zach Raderstorff has been patched up. He's got a big bandage on his right elbow. He returns for Twin Lakes. And we get Jordan Oakley back into the Jeff lineup, replacing Shane Wyatt.
Well, Eric, you're exactly right. He's now got bandages on both of his knees as well as that right elbow.
Yeah, so he's a walking wounded out there right now for the Indians, but he's all bandaged up. Hassan with it. Left wing. He's going to hand off here to Martinez. Top of the key. He'll run the play. Martinez tries to drive, cut off by Koger to McClintock, high post. McClintock to Hassan. Hassan comes down the lane. Nice drive, and he scores. He's got 8 in the quarter. It's 50-43, Jeff. So every time Jeff pulls out by 11, the Indians do make a run. Gamble trying to go coast to coast, and he's going to be pushed from behind here by an Indian defender. Foul's going to go against Tiburcio Martinez. That's his fourth person, and he'll check out. He's going to be replaced by Grant Billings. Joe Gamble inbounding in front of the Jeff bench. Gets it into Williams. Williams on the dribble, pulls it out to the half-court line. Back to Gamble on the right wing, and then right back out high to Williams again. Williams on the dribble. Williams dribbles to his right, near corner to Munoz. Munoz picks up, he's dribbled down the baseline to Oakley. Oakley puts his head down, drives the baseline. Now dishes to Koger. Pull-up jumper, left corner is good, but wave off the basket. Blaine Koger called for a travel, the 12th turnover by the Broncos. 108 to go now, third quarter. Jeff by 7, 50-43. Raderstorff with the ball. He brings it in the front court for Twin Lakes. Left wing. Still on the dribble, Raderstorff. Now he comes inside, and he's going to be fouled. Got another Bronco foul. They're 15 foul at a half. Jordan Oakley with the foul, his second. Team's fifth, as I said. 55 seconds to go, third quarter. Jeff leading 50-43. Twin Lakes with the ball. Baseline left front court. Raderstorff inbounding here. We're having trouble inbounding here. He's going to throw it all the way into the backcourt to Hassan. Good decision there by Raderstorff to beat that five count. Hassan with it back into the front court. Picked up by Gamble defensively to Raderstorff. Top of the key. Munoz, the defensive assignment there. Raderstorff on the dribble. He spins. Gets it to Logan. Logan comes down the right side of the lane. Dishes far corner. McClintock shot long. Hassan a rebound. And another Bronco foul. And boy, as you said earlier, Paul, Hassan has just been all over the floor tonight for the Indians.
Yeah, he looks like he might even be on pace to pick up a triple-double here in the game with double digits in points, rebounds, and assists.
And Joe Gamble picked up his fourth personal foul for the Broncos. Team's foul number 6. He'll check out. Timmy Fogarty back in. Inbounds pass to Hassan near corner. Hassan tries to drive on Fogarty. Nothing there. Now to Raderstorff. Top of the key. Three ball is short. Rebound grabbed by Koger of the Broncos. Koger into the front court to Munoz. Far corner. Now to Williams. Williams top of the key to Koger. Near corner to Fogarty. Down the baseline to Oakley. Guarded closely by McClintock. And the Indians try to get a steal. Hassan stepped on the sideline as he nearly came away with a steal. It's still Bronco ball. 13 seconds to go in the quarter. 50-43 is their lead.
That was good effort there by Hassan, but even if he had managed to not step out of bounds, he would have tossed it right to a Jeff defender.
Munoz with the ball, top of the key, 10 seconds to go in the quarter. He comes down the left side of the lane, and his layup attempt, no good. Rebound to Raderstorff, 3 seconds to go. Raderstorff in the backcourt will not be able to get a shot off as the third quarter buzzer sounds, and Jeff leads 50-43 after the third quarter. That was a situation.
public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, the Ad Council, and this station.
Jeff up by seven. They've got the ball. Munoz on a drive down the lane for the Broncos. He is fouled in the act of shooting, so Caesar will step to the foul line for the first time here this evening. He's got 7 points for the Jeff Broncos as the foul was called on Chandler Hassan. Just his first foul of the ballgame. Third team foul against the Indians.
Hard to believe he's only got one foul for how much he's been all over the floor tonight.
Munoz missed the foul shot, so he's 0 of 1 from the foul line. Caesar with 7 points tonight. This is on the heels of a 37-point performance in the season opener against Rossville. Of course, can't be expected to get 37 every night out, but he's been in foul trouble tonight as he makes the second free throw. 51-43. Jeff on top. Little token full-court pressure by the Broncos. Front court with it is Runyon for the Indians. And he bounces to Royce, back to Runyon, right wing. He dribbles, he loses the ball. Ball still loose, and Oakley grabs it for Jeff, but he lost it out of bounds, so that'll be a Broncos turnover. Their 13th. 16 turnovers for the Indians. 51-43, Jeff, 7:35 to go in the contest. We got Williams, Koger, Munoz. And we get a charge here. Fogarty draws that charge on the baseline for the Broncos. Fogarty and Oakley, the final two players on the floor right now for the Broncos. Zach Raiderstorff, the offensive foul, his first for Twin Lakes. Twin Lakes with four team fouls. Williams the ball, front court for Jeff. Right wing on the dribble, cross court pass to Fogarty. Fogarty pitches down low to a wide open Oakley. Oakley now into double figures with 10, and the Jeff lead is 10, 53-43. On the other end, driving down the left baseline and scoring is Tyler Runyon. He's got 4 points, 53-45 Jeff. On the other end, Jeff quickly at the fourth, rebound near corner. Koger, he hits again from the corner. 14 for Blaine, 56-45. The third different time tonight, Jeff has had an 11-point lead now. Hassan with the ball, front court for the Indians. High post to McClintock. Left wing Raiderstorff comes down the baseline, and it's another charge. Another charge against Raiderstorff. So he's been hit with two charges here in the last 30 seconds or so. Team foul number 5 against the Indians. 6:40 to go in the contest. 56-45, Jeff. Williams with the ball, front court for the Broncos on the dribble. Left wing three ball by Munoz is buried. Caesar with his second three of the ball game. Now he's got 11 points for the Broncos. 59-45 in favor.
Yeah, it looks like they're on the verge of doing just that, but they'll need some more of the same hustle. It looks like Blaine Koger is doing that right now.
Martinez with the ball, front court for the Indians. He's in the lane, bounces top of the key to Logan. Pull-up jumper to foul line by Logan, and he hits it. Nice little step-in move by Logan off the dribble. He's got 4, 59-47. Jeff right back up the floor. Williams, he's double-teamed to Koger, right wing. Bounces down low to Oakley. Great spin. Cross-court pass to Munoz in the corner. And Munoz had the ball taken away by Logan, but then we get a foul here called. Going to go on Caesar Munoz. Munoz called for that foul, I believe, after Logan took the ball away from him. So that'll be a Bronco turnover. They're 14th, and Munoz just picked up his fourth personal foul. And he definitely saved a bucket there by committing that foul, but that might have been one where you just might have rather given up the bucket there, Paul, rather than Munoz picking up his fourth foul.
Yeah, the fourth foul, that's trouble for Munoz. One more and he's gone, and the Broncos really need him in the game, even though he's not producing nearly as much as he was last game. They really need him in there just even to produce opportunities for the other players.
And it was the 17 foul against the Jeff Broncos as well, so that's going to be a 1-1 for the Indians here as they're down by 12, 59-47 with 6:06 to go here in the fourth quarter. Brady Logan, the free throw shooter, he's not been to the foul line tonight. He's got 4 points in the ball game. Logan's free throw is good. Got the roll. Well, Jeff's going to make a substitution. Joe Gamble's going to check in, replacing Timmy Fogarty. So Cesar Munoz is going to stay in the ballgame here for the Broncos with four personal fouls with 6:06 to go in the game.
Interesting move by Coach Bunnell. I thought Gamble was going to come in to replace Munoz, but he's going to take a chance and leave Munoz in right now in the game.
10-point lead for the Broncos. They've got the ball. Williams with it. Front court. Wants to drive inside. Puts one up off the glass and scores. Beautiful move by Brandon Williams. He's got 4 points. 61-49 Broncos. We'll see if the Indians try to go at Munoz here and pick up that fifth foul here on offense. Martinez with it, front court, top of the key, guarded closely by Koger to Logan, top of the key. Logan comes inside, and now we get a holding foul here. This will go against the Jet Broncos, and I think Logan will step back to the foul line again for Twin Lakes for another 1-1 as Jordan Oakley called for his third personal, team's eighth. Brady Logan hit two free throws just a moment ago for the Indians. His free throw is no good. It rattled out. Oakley with the rebound for Jeff. He sends it into the front court to Munoz, far sideline. Caesar pulls it out. Top of the key, far sideline to Gamble. Gamble on the dribble, moves to his right. Bounce pass inside to Koger, intercepted by the Indians. Martinez with the ball, front court. Near corner, passing a three balls off the mark. Rebound tipped, and it goes out of bounds. Back to the Jet Broncos. 5:13 to go now in the contest. 61-49 Broncos. And then Brandon Williams is going to walk the ball into the front court this time for Jeff.
That might be the first time tonight he's done that.
That's right. The Indians try to double-team him, and they're going to commit a foul. One of two players is going to get it. It's either going to be Logan or Martinez. And it's going to go against Tiburcio Martinez, and he's done. He just picked up his fifth foul, so his eligibility has expired in this ball game, and he'll foul out with 9 points. He'll be replaced by Tyler Royce. We're going to get a timeout now. On the floor, going to be called by the Lafayette Jet Broncos. 5:05 to go here in the fourth quarter. Jeff by a dozen, leading far sideline as Gamble inbounds to Williams. Williams with the ball front court to Koger on the right wing. Passing the defensive assignment in the lane to Gamble. To Munoz. The Indians now in a zone defense, I think, out of that timeout. Munoz drives the left side of the lane, fouled on his way to the bucket. Caesar to the line for two free throw opportunities here. Caesar's got 12 points in the ball, actually 11 points in the ball game, and he's one of two from the foul line as the personal foul is called on Brady Logan, his fourth, team seven. Caesar Munoz, the free throw shooter, he's got 6 points in this half. His free throw is no good, so his free throw form a little off tonight. He's missed two out of three attempts there. Caesar dribbles on the second. It's in the air. Got the roll on this one. 62-49 Broncos. Twin Lakes ball in backcourt. Royce with the ball. And he brings it into the front court, picked up by Blaine Koger. Far sideline to Raiderstorff. He moves to his left. Gamble hedges out on him. Raiderstorff comes down the lane. Missed the layup attempt. Rebound to Gamble. Gamble quickly up the floor. Comes down the lane. Near corner. Koger, another three in the corner. He missed this one. Rebound to Hassan for the Indians. And Chandler's going to bring the ball into the front court for Twin Lakes. He wants to go coast to coast. His layup attempt no good. Oakley grabbed the rebound. Had it taken away by Hassan, and he's scored. Hassan with 18 now in the basketball game, and that leads everybody in scoring. 62-51, Jeff. Front court, Gamble with the ball. He comes down the lane. Dishes down low to Oakley. A pump fake, and he scores. Jordan Oakley with 12. 64-51 Broncos. 3:54 to go in the contest.
Nice pass by Gamble as he drove toward the basket.
Royce with the ball, front court for the Indians. Out high to Raiderstorff, who calls out the play. Munoz, the defensive assignment on Raiderstorff. Left wing now to Royce. Royce drives down the baseline. A runner on the baseline way long. A rebound, though, underneath by McClintock. And he's fouled on the putback effort. So J.D. McClintock will be the free throw shooter for Twin Lakes, and he'll shoot two free throws. Oh, Jordan Oakley, the guilty party on the foul, his fourth. And I see Shane Wyatt getting up off the bench because Jordan may go to the bench here with 3:35 to go. McClintock at the foul line. He's got 6 points and make it seven. So Wyatt checks in replacing Oakley, and we get Grant Billings into the Twin Lakes lineup. Tyler Royce will take a seat. Point lead for Jeff. 3:35 to go in the contest. J.D. McClintock, one more free throw opportunity for Twin Lakes. It's in the air and it's good. Lead down to 11. Williams with the ball. A little full court pressure by the Indians. They nearly get a steal, but Gamble got it back in the lane. Gamble hangs in the lane and it wouldn't fall for him. It hung on the front of the rim, the ball did, then finally fell off. Billings with the ball, far corner to Logan. He drives down the baseline. He's double-teamed, and his pass is intercepted by Blaine Culver. Culver down the lane on the other end, puts it up, no. Rebound knocked around, out of bounds, back to the Twin Lakes Indians. With 3:08 to go, Jeff by 11, 64-53. Royce back in for the Indians, as well as Tyler Runyon. Billings and Logan go to the bench.
Twin Lakes is really trying to keep the tempo up here to try to get back in this ball game. They're down by 11. It's not looking good for them, but the Broncos are trying to keep the pace up as well, and they're playing a little bit sloppy here.
Jeff's led after every quarter, at one after the first, six at halftime, and seven after the third. Here's a steal. Williams missed the layup. Point blank range for Jeff, and the Indians grab the rebound, but then they step out of bounds in the far corner. So both teams turn it over, and we're right back where we started again with Jeff inbounding the basketball. Gamble inbounds. Actually, it was Twin Lakes who had the inbounds pass, and then Jeff got a steal, and Twin Lakes turned it back over. We got a big collision right in front of us here. As Raiders Storff and Munoz collide in the front court for Jeff, both diving for the basketball. Jeff's going to keep possession of the basketball. Good hustle by both individuals, but Jeff with the ball, leading by 11, 64-53. Raiders Storff with the inbounds pass. Actually, it's Twin Lakes ball. Indians with the basketball. It's Runyon with it on the left wing. Out to Royce, who directs traffic. Now to Hassan. 2:40 to go in the contest. Twin Lakes down by 11. Runyon with the top of the key, guarded by Munoz. Runyon on the drive. Pass is deflected, taken away by Williams. Two on one. Nice bounce pass across the court, and scoring is Blaine Culver. What a bounce pass by Williams there, Paul. That was fantastic.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't be surprised if Williams becomes the starting point guard for the Jets just based on his performance in tonight's game.
65-53. Twin Lakes misses a shot on the other end. Gamble drives down the floor, and he draws a foul. Zach Raidersdorf with his third personal. And now it's going to be Joe Gamble, the free throw shooter. He'll shoot a 1-1. 2:14 to go in the game. Jeff by 13, 66-53. Logan and Billings back into the lineup for Twin Lakes. Royce and Runyon to the bench. Coach Ken Adams is making offensive and defensive substitutions here. Jeff by 13. They're looking good right now for a broken Friday night semifinals of JMC Hoops Classic. As Gamble's free throw is no good. Rebound to Hassan of the Indians. Raiders throw up with it in front court. Right side of the lane to McClintock. Bounces back out high to Raiderstorff. Raiderstorff tries to come down the lane. Lost the ball. It's going to go out of bounds. Off Zach's foot out of bounds. And that's the 20th turnover against the Indians. With 157 to go, and Jeff holding a 13-point lead. Munoz up the far sideline into the front court. Dishes on the baseline to Wyatt, and he lost the ball. We're going to get a holding foul on the baseline. So Shane Wyatt's going to shoot two free throws here for the Broncos as Jeff is in the double bonus.
Hey, interesting play there. Wyatt looked like he bobbled the ball as he was receiving the pass, then bobbled it again as he was going up in the air, but he was fouled on the shot, and he'll shoot two free throws here.
Brady Logan fouls out of the ball game for the Twin Lakes. The Indians replaced by David Schulteis. Wyatt, two free throws. The sophomore with 6 points in the ball game, make it seven. He buries his first free throw attempt. Shane's second free throw is no good, a little strong. Rebound to Hassan for the Indians. Now to Raiderstorff. Raiderstorff across the half-court circle, or half-court line, rather. 67-53, Jeff, 1:40 to go. Schulteis with the ball. To McClintic, near corner to Raiderstorff. Pulls up for a 15-footer in the corner, and he hits. Zach Raiderstorff with seven. 67-55, Jeff. Munoz with the ball, front court, far sideline for the Broncos to Gamble. He dishes down low to Wyatt. Wyatt missed the shot. Rebound to Wyatt. We're going to have, I think, another Twin Lakes foul here. We'll wait and see.
Twin Lakes foul to David Schulteis.
David Schulteis with his first foul. And Shane Wyatt, two free throws. Jeff in the double bonus. Shane's free throw is good. He got the roll. He's got 8 points now. 2 of 3 from the free throw line. 68-55. If Shane makes this, this will match Jeff's largest lead of the night. And he can't do it. Rebound to Hassan for the Indians. Behind the back dribble for Chandler. He bounces to Raiderstorff. Raiderstorff up the far sideline into the front court. Far corner to Billings. Billings to Raiderstorff. He's in the near corner. Thought about the three. His pass deflected. Stolen away by Gamble. But Gamble stepped on the sideline out of bounds, so he'll give it right back to the Indians. With 1:02 to go, Jeff leading 68-55. Lafayette Jeff is led throughout in this one. Raiderstorff inbounds to McClintic. Back to Raiderstorff, down the near side, near baseline, rather, and he scores. Raiderstorff with 9, 68-57. Jeff turns it over here. Their 18th turnover with 53 seconds to go. They've got an 11-point lead.
Jeff has definitely played somewhat of a sloppy game, offset by the sloppiness of Twin Lakes as well. But I've been impressed at how they've played an up-tempo offense for the whole game. Really haven't slowed the ball down at all throughout this entire game.
Schulteis, the inbound pass to Royce with 50 seconds to go here. Royce into the front court on the dribble, guarded closely by Williams. Royce inside. What a block by Williams. They're going to call a foul here, though, by Williams. He really got up in the air there, but he does pick up a foul. His second personal foul, and team's 10th. Double bonus time for Twin Lakes, but really have been impressed. I think both of us have, Paul, by Brandon Williams' performance tonight.
Yeah, that was quickly a clean foul to me, but as the refs call goes, and you're exactly right, Brandon Williams has played a great game so far tonight.
Sophomore with two personals as the free throw is made by Royce. Tyler Royce with 4 points. Royce makes a pair. 43 seconds to go. Jeff with the ball in the front court. Gamble with the top of the key. 68-59 Broncos in this one. Gamble now drives inside. Puts one up off the glass. Wouldn't fall. Wyatt tried to tip it and wouldn't go. Rebounded out by Jeff with 24 seconds to go. Williams with it to Koger. Koger double teamed and fouled. Foul going to be called on Chandler Hassan, his second. Two free throws for Blaine Koger with 21 seconds to go. Jeff by 9. Koger has 16 points in the ballgame. That leads all Broncos in scoring tonight. His free throw is no good. Timmy Fogarty back in for the Broncos, replacing Shane Wyatt. A.J. Ellis back in for the Indians, as well as Darren Paul. We've got 21 seconds to go, and the Broncos are on their way to a semifinal appearance on Friday night as Koger makes one of two.
Chandler Hassan got a nice pat on the back from the referee as he went to the bench. He has had a great game for Twin Lakes Indians in this unsuccessful game for them.
On the other end, we get a layup good by Darren Paul. 8 seconds to go. Koger right back down the floor, and he draws a foul on a shot. Wouldn't fall for Blaine, but he's back to the foul line for two more free throw opportunities. 69-61 Jeff with 7 seconds to go. Koger eyes the free throw. It's in the air, and it's good. 70-61 now. And we get a stoppage of play here as Koger made the first free throw, and the official gave the ball to Twin Lakes, and Twin Lakes came back up the floor. I think Koger only had one free throw, right?
He was fouled as he went up for the shot. I believe he missed the shot.
I thought he only shot one free throw, and he made it. He should have two free throws. The officials are going to correct the error here, and Koger's going to have a second free throw.
Yeah, look, Broncos overall tonight have not done very well from the free throw line. I'm not sure of the entire statistics, but it seems like they have had trouble shooting from the charity stripe tonight.
So Koger will get his second free throw here. Clock has been reset to 7.1 seconds. 70-61. Koger's second free throw is missed. So I guess it didn't really make any difference anyway in the whole realm here. It's a three ball missed on the other end by Royce. A shot at the buzzer by Billings is good. No. No good. The official waved it off, I believe. 70-61. You're